offensive.
Watching the various television channels, very few reported very much the Congo and a short piece on France 24. That was about all. And so the demonstrations need to also say something to the media in Britain about what is going on. Because I have tabled a motion to the British Parliament on Monday night, in which I have studied the Carter Centre report on the elections, the European Union report on the elections, and the United Nations report on the elections, and I've also since heard of the statements made from the Archbishop. And the Carter Centre reported very strange things such as 100% turnout in some areas. That is impossible anywhere in the world. Declared votes, and therefore the decision by the Electoral Commission to declare Kabila elected on the basis of all the criticisms and reports that have been put forward is simply not right. That's why we're here today. So what I think we have to do is ask that they make the point that all the world's governments, if they are serious about bringing about democracy in any society, where the international observers all say the elections were not free, not fair, and not a representation of the wishes of those people, then they call into question why they have since recognised the appointment of Kabila as president once again. So our demands are for free elections in the Congo, are for transparency in it. But there is a wider agenda, and I'll finish on this point. The Congo has been disgracefully treated ever since the colonialists first arrived, that's for sure. The abuse of human rights, the loss of life, the civil war, yet great riches have been made from the Congo by mining companies and many others all over the world. All the mobile phones in our country, and the culture, and all the other issues. So I hope in this period we're making demands for free and fair elections. We're making demands for justice for the people of Congo. And in my visits to the Congo, I've been twice, I was shocked by the way in which women particularly have been treated, the way in which rape has been used as a weapon of war, the way in which the police and armed forces seem completely unwilling or incapable of doing anything about it, yet the riches still roll out of the Congo. What we want, surely, is independence, yes, obviously, justice with it, and the world to stand up and not support elections that are clearly, blatantly unfair and not a true representation of the wish of the people of the Congo. I put that motion to the British Parliament. A number of colleagues, John McDonnell, Andy Love, Peter Bottomley and others have signed that motion. I think you should all... When Parliament returns on January the 10th, we'll be taking up the issue again and organising meetings on it. But we have to get the message to the media that the issue of democracy in the Congo isn't some distant, faraway place.